We've got a high precision GPS survey grade receiver. It's the same piece of kit that our surveyors use every day, 250 surveyors surveying the land. And it can track 20, 30 satellites instantaneously every second. The satellites are 20,000 kilometres in the sky, travelling at several thousand kilometres an hour. But this is still able to record that fine data every second, hundreds of observations a second. The network of base stations, there's 109 separate base stations around the country. So we use those as a reference framework, and we compute the position of this kit relative to that fixed reference framework. There's some quite complex computations that need to be done on the data. It's not something that just drops out of the kit in a couple of minutes. In fact, you have to wait almost 2 weeks before you can even start the computations, because you need certain accurate orbits and Earth rotation models to be made available from scientific institutions around the world to use those in the computations in order to get that best possible height answer. And it's all designed to model out all the possible errors that might be in the GPS signal, like atmosphere, troposphere, ionosphere, and all the other things that contribute to making the signal a bit fuzzy. The GPS signal's quite weak, actually. The analogy I once heard was if you were stood at John O'Groats with a strong torch, it's like getting someone at Land's End to try to see that torch under certain circumstances. But this is able to hang on to those signals and track them, even in the harshest conditions, which when this was up on Ben Nevis was quite severe weather. So it does a very good job of hanging on to those very weak signals. This software is able to model them out and arrive at the kind of the core information that's hidden in there.